In the last video, I briefly compared Raman scattering with IR absorption. Though Raman has many advantages, the application of the Raman technique is sometimes more challenging due to its natural enemy, the fluorescence.
But of course, fluorescence is not all bad. For example, fluorescence marking is a safeguard against the counterfeiting of banknote. If you expose a $20 bill to a violet light, a security mark will start to glow green. The same effect can occur in a Raman experiment. A molecule absorbs high-energy photon and achieves an electronically excited state. From this excited state, it may relax back to the ground state and emit a photon with less energy and longer wavelength. The fluorescence effect is fundamentally different from Raman scattering process, although both effects result in photons with longer wavelength, and a detector will not discriminate between Raman scattered light and the light emitted by fluorescence. A fluorescence spectrum appears much broader than Raman and does not hold information of molecular vibration. If unexpected fluorescence happens, not everything is lost. For mild fluorescence interference, we can remove the broad fluorescence background in data processing. However, light emitted during fluorescence is often much more intense than Raman scattered light and will literally flood the detector. But there are methods to stop a sample from fluorescing. One of the easiest is changing the laser wavelength. If green and blue are not working, you should change the laser wavelength to a lower energy. Generally speaking, red and near-infrared photons have lower energy and usually don't excite molecules electronically. Also, if a sample is colored, the laser of the same color is less likely to be absorbed and cause the fluorescence effect. Next time, I will explain which lasers are most used in Raman spectroscopy and why they are so popular.